Good day, it's Teacher Jo. Yung mga nursery rhymes sa English na alam kong alam ninyo dahil napapanood nyo ito sa Cocomelons. Twinkle, twinkle, daddy finger, where are you? The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round. And meron din tayong Filipino versions, syempre. Ba natin tinuturo yan? Dahil ba mabilis makabisa ng mga bata o dahil ang cute lang talaga ng mga bagets kapag kinakanta nila yan? Regardless of the reason why, it is actually a must to teach these nursery rhymes to the kids. Right? Simply because it promotes phonological awareness, which is one of the 6 pre-reading skills your child needs to acquire before he or she is able to read. And yun din talaga yung original reason kaya naimbento yung mga nursery rhymes na yan. Again, what is phonological awareness? It is the ability to hear that words are made up of smaller sounds. For example, itong word na kamusta. Kaya natin yan nababanggit na sasabi kasi meron yung mga letra at tunog na k, a, m, u, s, t, a. At we blend the letter sounds and we come up with kamusta. Narinig niyo po ba yung mga smaller sounds na yun? If you did, then your awareness of phonemes are well-developed. Pero sa bagets, hindi pa po. And we want our kids to develop that awareness. And buti na lang, may napakasimpleng paraan. By exposing and teaching them nursery rhymes. Kasi ano ba ang nursery rhymes? These are short songs or verses customarily told or sung to young children. Yes, hindi po need talaga na mag-rhyme ang isang nursery rhyme. Kaya lang yung most nursery rhymes ay nag-rhyme kasi nga catchy siyang pakinggan at mas appealing sa mga younger children. So, paano makakatulong itong nursery rhymes ma-develop ang phonological awareness? In a nutshell, they help develop an ear for language.
Okay.
They hear words can rhyme or sound alike, like this song. Jack and Jill went up the hill. They hear a beat or rhythm on how words are said, like this one. They hear how words can be divided by its syllables. Ito, alam ko narinig at nalaro nyo na rin to. Pen, pen, de sara, pen, de cuchillo, de almacen. They hear very simple stories that are easy to understand. Like in this one, nagas nyo ba kung anong kwento niyan? And they hear it from you. Kaya sana po, to end this video, don't let YouTube be the only access or source of your children to hear nursery rhymes. Sana sa inyo po nila ito unang marinig.